Hello, welcome back to Guidancy Education Channel. In this video, we are going to discuss relation for refraction at single spherical surface, concave surface, ray passing from rarer to denser medium. This is part 3 in this series. I have prepared a diagram here where O is the object and it is facing the concave surface. Before we go into the details, please watch the video completely, and if you think the video is useful, like the video, share the video, and please subscribe to my channel. Leave your comments in the comment box below so that I can know your thinking of the video. That will be a great motivation for me. Thank you very much. Now let us see the details. O is the object, a luminous body kept in front of the concave surface. This is the rarer medium. The other side is the denser medium. N1 is the refractive index of the rarer medium and N2 the refractive index of denser medium. A ray starting from O passes along this line and strikes the concave surface at A. If refraction did not occur, it would have passed along this line. NC is the normal drawn at that point. As you already know, normal drawn at a spherical surface will pass along the center of curvature. This distance is R. Since the ray is entering the denser medium, it bends towards the normal. This is the refracted ray. Another ray considered is the ray passing along the principal axis. That will pass on without deviation. So these two rays will never converge on this side. So as we usually do, these two rays are extended backwards, and it is at the point I that these two rays meet. So the virtual image is formed at I. All the details regarding the diagram I have given below. Let us go through that. All this is prepared in advance so that we can save some time. O, as you said, is the object. I is the image. C is the center of curvature. CP is R. P, as you know, is the pole of the surface. AM is the perpendicular drawn to this line OP. The curvature is very small. Therefore, we can take AM as equal to AP. Further, instead of taking AM, we will take AP. OAC, this angle, whole angle, OAC, this angle is the angle of incidence marked I. This is the angle of refraction R. This angle and this angle are opposite angles, so they are same. So we have taken angle of refraction on the inside, that is IAC, angle of refraction R. Angle AOC, this angle is marked as angle alpha. Angle AIC, this angle marked as beta. Angle ACP, this angle is gamma. From triangle OAC, this triangle, gamma is the exterior angle. For a triangle, the exterior angle is equal to sum of the interior opposite angles. Following that principle, we get gamma is equal to angle alpha plus angle of incidence, this angle. From this, you get an expression for I that is equal to gamma minus alpha. Similarly, for triangle IAC, here also gamma is the exterior angle. So the relationship changes. Gamma is equal to R plus beta. So R is equal to gamma minus beta. Now we need the tan value of these angles alpha, beta and gamma. So for small angles, tan alpha is equal to alpha, tan beta is equal to beta, tan gamma is equal to gamma. What is the reason? We will note it down here. Because angles are small. From triangle OAP, we have already said that instead of taking the point M, we will be taking P. This angle, we have taken it as alpha. We have already stated that tan alpha is equal to alpha, tan beta is equal to beta, tan gamma is equal to gamma. Alpha is equal to AP by PO. Similarly, triangle IAP, beta is equal to AP by PI. Triangle CAP, gamma is equal to again AP by PC. What are these distances? AP is common, that is a perpendicular. What are these values? PO, PI and PC. We have noted it here. PO is the distance of the object. By new Cartesian convention, the measurement is in the direction opposite to the direction of the incident light. Therefore, distance of the object is negative U. Similarly, PI is the distance of the image. It is negative V, and center of curvature R. PC equal to center of curvature is equal to negative R. All these quantities are all negative because all the measurements are in the opposite direction to the direction of the incident light. Okay. So, we have these expressions here for alpha, beta and gamma. Now, coming to Snell's law. Sin I by sin R is equal to N2 by N1. And for small angles, sin I is equal to I. Sin R is equal to R. Therefore, sin I becomes I. I by R is equal to N2 by N1. From this, you will have the expression N1I is equal to N2R. Now, we will substitute for the angles I and R. We have an expression I is equal to gamma minus alpha. This is gamma minus alpha. Similarly, N2R. What is the expression for R? R is equal to gamma minus beta. Gamma minus beta. We have expressions for gamma, alpha and beta. We are substituting that here. So, this becomes N1 into AP by PC minus AP by PU. All these things are here. N2 is equal to N2 into AP by PC minus AP by PI. AP is common on either side. So, we take it as N1 into 1 by PC minus 1 by PO is equal to N2 into 1 by PC minus 1 by PI. Opening up the brackets, we will get N1 by PC minus N1 by PO is equal to N2 by PC minus N2 by PI. This quantity and this quantity has the same denominator. So, we will take to the same side. So, what do we do? Let us bring this quantity over here. When this is carried over here, the negative is cancelled. So, it becomes N2 by PI minus this quantity. N1 by PO is equal to N2 minus N1. When this quantity is taken over there, it becomes negative. Minus N1. By PC. Let us substitute for PI, PO and PC. It becomes N2 by negative V minus N1 by negative U is equal to N2 minus N1 by what is PC is negative R. So, we get the expression N2 by negative V minus N1 by negative U is equal to N2 minus N1 by negative R. Here you have one negative sign, here also there is one negative sign. So, on further simplification, this portion becomes positive. So, it becomes equal to N2 by negative V plus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by negative R. Now, in the next step, this quantity is positive and this quantity is negative. We shift this quantity over to the first portion. So, it becomes N1 by U minus N2 by V is equal to N2 minus N1 by negative R. We want to remove this negative sign. We multiply this portion with a negative. In order to balance that, multiply on the left hand side with a negative. So, what happens? Negative N1 by U minus and minus becomes plus. Plus N2 by V is equal to N2 minus N1 by negative R into negative. So, it becomes positive. So, it becomes N2 minus N1 by R. This is the expression for refraction at concave surface producing virtual image. Let us compare the expression that we got for the three cases. For convex surface, we got an expression for real image and virtual image. Let us recall for real image, it was negative N1 by U plus N2 by V equal to N2 minus N1 by R. For virtual image, both these two equations are same. When we come to concave surface, the expression is negative n1 by u plus n2 by v equal to n2 minus n1 by r. This also is the same as the other. We can sum up that for refraction from rarer medium to denser medium, whether it is convex surface or concave surface, whether it is a real image or virtual image, the expression is the same, but the derivation part and the diagram are different. In the next video, we will discuss relation for refraction at convex and concave surface when the ray is passing from denser medium to rarer medium. Remember, the representation of the convex and concave surface is the same, but the only thing is the position of the object is changed. This is convex surface. For refraction from rarer to denser, the object was in rarer medium. For refraction at convex surface from denser to rarer, the representation of the surface is the same, but the object is kept in the denser medium. So also for concave surface. Okay, we will see the details of that in the next video. Hope all the three videos which we discussed now was clear. I would recommend that you watch all these three videos without much time gap so that you understand these points clearly, and you will also be able to differentiate the diagrammatic representations and the derivation part. Okay, thank you.